Welcome to Chicago. I'm Miss Lisa.
And I'm Ratzel.
Ratzel, what's wrong? You look a little perturbed.
Well, I'll tell you, Miss Lisa, I had some issues in school this week, so I had to deal with a bit of a detention situation.
Oh, really? Well, I can understand why that has you a little upset.
Well, that's not what's got me upset. I can do detention standing on my head, sister. But the problem is I didn't have any time to pick records out for this week's show.
You didn't have time to pick out any...
No,
Ratzel, that's terrible. The show's ruined.
No. Come on. If the show was ruined, you think I'd show up? My tail would be halfway to Tijuana to hide out with my cousin Ratty Gonzalez. I took care of the situation. I got Joe at Hi-Fi Records to pick some songs out on the show. That's why I'm upset.
What, did he pick out bad songs or something?
No. Because the songs he picked out were so funky. I just don't think this crowd is funky enough to get down to these jams.
What? Hey, hold up. I don't think... You don't think we're funky? These are the best dancers on all of TV. Did you guys hear that? He called us unfunky.
But on Attack of the Boogie, they said we didn't know how to get down.
Attack of the... Oh, no. All right, y'all. We're going to have to get funky, okay? Do we know how to get funky? We know how to get funky. All right, look out. Up next...
Oh, is that no?
All right. You just watch this camera work. You watch the feet. Let's see. We're going to show them a thing or two, all right? Up next is Emmanuel Coppola's Legend of a Cowgirl. Roll that funky tape, Bill.
Woo! Show these people how funky you are.
You want F-U-N-K-Y? We're in control. All right, speaking of cowgirls, here is a song about a cowboy. In fact, he is one of the great heroes of legends and tall tales. Here is Cruel, Cruel Moon singing about the famous Pecos Bill. Roll that funky tape, Bill. We'll be right back. situation that happens, this comes up all the time. You want to get funky, but you're short on cash. Now, what do?
You can open a funky chart. And here's Jerry O telling us about how to do it.
I needed that. Okay. And now, we have up next our excellent guests who are here to perform a song from their new album, Gospel Morning. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, cats and kittens, here's internationally acclaimed Chamber Strings.
The night.
That was lovely. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have to come around and get all of your names. Can you tell me your name?
Kevin Jr.
And back here?
Tim.
Hi, Tim.
I'm Anthony.
Velarde.
What's your name?
I'm Miss Lisa. Everybody knows me. Come on. It's my show. No, I'm sorry. What's your name?
Ellis.
Well, good to meet you. It was wonderful having you. I wasn't sure what kind of music we would get out of an album named Gospel Morning, but it was... How would you characterize your music?
I'd say it's a rock and roll band, and lots of things in between.
So when did you guys get started playing together? I think you mentioned that you're all members, you've been musicians in the Chicago music scene for a while, but that the band is... The band is new.
Yeah, about a year we've been playing together, and we've known each other for years before that.
So this is your first album, then?
Yes, as the Chamber Strings.
As the Chamber Strings.
Collectively, we've got about 40 between us.
Wow.
Maybe 50. Probably by next month, 60.
It just keeps growing exponentially. You're not sure, yeah. But this album, this is available today in record stores.
Yes, it is.
Great, and you have a gig tonight, don't you?
Yes, we do.
At the Double Door, but, oh, well.
I guess by the time the Chicago audience sees this, you won't be at the Double Door necessarily that night, but you can go out and get the album today. Yeah, well, you might be. That's entirely possible, right. Well, thank you so much for joining us today, and look for the album. It's in stores, Chamber Strings, Gospel Morning. Now, I know you have some place to be tonight, and you have your gig, but I hope that you'll stick around for a couple of minutes. You have hours, yeah. I have to go. If you have time, the next song is Eddie Harris. It's called It's All Right Now, and we'd love if you could stay around and dance with us. In fact, everybody, come on up. Come back up. Join us. Thanks again. Funky, okay? But as you guys know, the Chicagogo dancers and crafts and crew members, we are multi-talented, and just to prove that, I want to introduce one of our dancers. Tell me what your name is.
Sean.
Sean is here to share with us a few of his jokes. He's a burgeoning comedian.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Mike.
Mike who?
Mike Hay stuck in a tree.
That's very good. What, did you have another one, or?
Sure. That meatloaf was good for hammering nails with.
Great.
And my last joke What do you call a grandfather clock?
I don't know. What do you call a grandfather clock?
An old timer.
Thank you. Excellent. Thank you very much. Take a bow. All right. Well, our next songs are actually are kind of about little boys. our next group, no, nothing untoward here. The next group is called the Fast Boys, and it's called, the song is Boys Will Be Boys.
Gator Ralph, would you like to meet some of our Chicka Go Go dancers? What's your name, little fella?
Luna.
How about you?
Brandon.
Brandon? What's your name, miss?
Estella.
Okay, what's your name?
Tanya.
We all having a good time on the show?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we'd like to play a fun game now. It's in honor of Black History Month, you know, this is a historical kind of question. Right now, we'd like you to try and unscramble the name of a famous black explorer who was the first black explorer to find Chicago. It's kind of a hard puzzle. Do you want a hint? Do you want a hint? Yeah? Okay, there's also a name of a school and a black history museum named after this person. If that helps? Well, while you're working on that, let's listen to a rad hit by a fatback called Mr. Bassman.
One of the funkiest bands on the East Coast, the Fatback Band. Come on!
Thank you.
That's right. We proved we are just as funky, if not funkier, than all those other dance programs on TV. Thank you very much. What are you... Wait. What are you ha-ha-ing about?
They didn't say anything about us on those other shows. Attack of the Boogie last week was a rerun from 1988. I just made that up to motivate. Reverse psychology.
You little tricky rat.
Speaking of psychology, here's a joke. A guy walks into a psychiatrist's office with a cast on his leg and a black eye and a sling on his arm and a missing tooth. And the doctor looks at him and he's shocked. What happened, man? You were fine when you left my office yesterday. So the guy says, I just followed your prescription, doc. So the doctor says, what do you mean you followed my prescription? It was just for some headache pills. So the guy says, you ready for this, Lisa?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, but the prescription blew out of my hands and I followed it out the window.
Oh.
Yeah, well, that other kid's got more practice.
Okay. That was pretty funky. Bad. In fact, I think the only thing that could possibly be funkier than that would be James Brown doing
Wait,
hot
no, it's
pants.
Not James Brown, it's Parliament doing
it's
the
Parliament.
Mothership Connection.
They're doing the who?
The Mothership Connection.
The Mothership Connection?
That's funky.
Okay, that's funky. I must have the wrong show.
Ooh, my fault.
It is James Brown doing that's hot funky. Pants. Bye bye.
Funky.
The universe, recording angel. We have returned to claim the pyramid. Partying on the mothership. I am the mothership connection. Getting down in 3D. Light year groove. Well, all right. You hear the noise? Ain't nobody but me and the boy. Get down. Hit it, fellas. Fries and dip in your hip and come on to the mothership. Loose boot, doing the bump. Hustle on over here. The bomb.